In the previous video, we started looking at the principles of DevOps, and what we're going to start doing is automating everything that should be automated. We also talked about shifting bottlenecks to the left, where coding is a creative process. But what happened after your code is ready, the feature is ready, everything else should just be automated. And that also includes build automation, test automation, running all your tests, almost all your tests. Also, how the way you deploy your product. Also, even while developing, when the developers need the new environment to be created, that should also be automated. And we'll start correlating this with our environment, infrastructure lifecycle events, and start looking at what are the tools that we could use for automating things. Now, talking about environment automation, an environment, a dev environment that we're talking about, should just be production-like. So one of the common issues is, you know, not having the dev prod parity, where developers may have their own version of local environments and everything works there, but when it goes to the staging or production, things start breaking. And the reason for that is environment inconsistency. So environment should be production-like. Environment creation process just should be automated. There is no reason why this should be a manual process. It's good to have a self-service portal so that the developers can go and provision their own environments by themselves as well. Now, what is involved in automating the environments? Let's have a look. When you talk about provisioning a server, it could be a server, a bare metal server, it could be a VM, it could be a cloud server. You can use different tools for automating different types of provisioning configuration. And once you provision the servers, then you want to configure. Let's say you brought up a VM. Now you want to install some applications. Could be, you know, installing, let's say a node application needs a node stack and npm installed. A Java application needs JDK installed, maybe a Tomcat as well. Or for building, you need a Maven to be installed. So you install and configure all those applications before you start and before you launch your applications and start building the process, right? So that provisioning can be automated using various different tools. So if it is a bare metal system, you could use tools such as Cobbler and Razor and Kickstart and Precede to, since you don't have APIs, you'll have to rely on some sort of a network boot. And all of these, almost all of these tools will use network boot. And then some of those will also help you make some intelligent decisions such as Razor. Next is cloud. Cloud is something that has become a commonplace, and cloud has actually started a lot of, you know, the agile processes and practices were started by the companies who were building products for and on the cloud, right? And the advantage of using cloud, it's not just a public cloud. You can also set up your own private cloud. A lot of organizations today who have been running their own data centers also have their own private cloud, such as OpenStack, for the same reason. It's the self-serviceability that it gives you, so that your developers don't have to wait for someone to provision the infrastructure for them. They can programmatically do it, or they can go to a portal and they can just ask for a server and it gets provisioned within minutes. And all of a lot of clouds, public clouds, also offer managed services, which reduce your time of provisioning, managing, operating those components. For example, a managed database gives you automated backups, recovery, you can also do the regional failovers and stuff like that. So all of that is managed. So that's pretty good to have. Automation is another thing that cloud gives you. It gives you an ability to automate almost everything. And since we're talking about automating stuff with DevOps, cloud becomes sort of a core component of that, because that's where we start automating stuff. And on top of cloud, we start building and, you know, provisioning our own infrastructure. And sometimes it's a software as a service or platform as a service that we build on top of that. Cloud also gives you an ability to dynamically provision infrastructure. That's very useful. So in this video, we talked about why environment automation is needed, what all can be automated, what are the phases of your environment creation and provisioning and configuration, and also talked about cloud. In the next one, we're going to talk about the tools which allow us to write infrastructure as a code.